This drug is Paatha, Sesampelus paraira. Sesampelus paraira from the family Menispermaceae. So, this plant is a climber. You can see that this is a climber, a weak stemmed plant which twines around the support. So, this is a climber. And you can see that the leaves is orbicular, round. So that it has a synonym called as Vruttaparni. And another synonym, Aviddha Karnika. Can you see this? The petiole of the leaf is attached here. Not just at the base, but just above the base. So this nature is called as peltate. So this is Aviddha Karnika. As this is above the base, the petiole is attached. So it is called as Aviddha Karnika. And you can see the dominance of three nerves. The dominance of three nerves, and hence it is called as Trishira. So it is tasting as a bitter, so it is Tiktika, Varatikta, many other synonyms. It's a climber with the orbicular, the leaves simple, orbicular, or you can take it as cardate. See, the shape of the leaf is cardate and ovate. Broad at the base and gradually tapered to apex. So this is called as ovate. So it is, the leaf is orbicular, cardate, ovate, or you can call it as also reniform. See, if you hold like this, you can see like it is kidney shaped, right? So it is reniform. So orbicular, cardate, ovate, reniform shape, and then flowers is greenish yellow in the axillary racemes. You can see this. This is the axil. If it is a leaf, at the axil, we can find the inflorescence. So axillary racemes, and there actually greenish yellow color flowers. It has dried so that you are looking like this. So whatever this pale green structure which is looking here is a bract. Bract means a leaf-like structure which is there on the inflorescence axis or on the flower stalk. So that is called as bracts. Okay. So this is an inflorescence, greenish yellow inflorescence, and fruit will be round or globose and red when ripe. So this is about the Sesampelus paraira, what it is called as Paatha. There is another drug which is named in the taken in the name of Paatha, that is Rajapaatha. So I'll show you that Rajapaatha now for you. So I had plucked the Rajapaatha plant, a climber, from the other place. See, this is Rajapaatha. This is also a climber. Okay. And you can see that the leaves are simple, alternate. And then, see, this lamina is in deltoid shape. That is isobilateral. See, this is a triangle shaped. See here, both the sides are parallel, and this is somewhat triangular. So this is called as deltoid. This shape is called as deltoid. And we can appreciate the peltate nature of the petiole here more. See here, actually usually all the leaves, the petioles will be attached here. But here, just above this base of the leaf, this petiole is attached. So this nature, we will call it as peltate. Peltate. The leaf is peltate. We'll call it as the leaf is peltate. So it's a climber. So this is called as Rajapaatha Cyclia peltata. Rajapaatha Cyclia peltata from the family, same Menispermaceae family as the Paatha family itself. This is Rajapaatha Cyclia peltata, Menispermaceae family. Leaves simple, alternate. Lamina is deltoid, or that is triangular in shape. And flowers are somewhat greenish white, minute in nature. And about the fruits, see, this fruits will be a bunch of fruits like a grapes, but very small in size. And that bunch, there will be berries. There will be berries. If you say it is berries, the fruit is completely fleshy, except only the seeds are the hard part. Except only the seeds are hard parts. So here there will be bunch of the this type of fruits, which will be greenish. And when it is ripen, it will become completely white. When it is ripen, it will be completely white or creamish white. We can say it as creamish white, drupaceous berries. We can call it as drupaceous fruits. Okay. So, this is Rajapata. So, in the name of Pata, we are considering two drugs. One is Sisampalus Paraira and another one is Cyclia Peltata. Sisampalus Paraira, we will call it as Lagupata, and this Cyclia Peltata, we will call it as Rajapata. Okay. So, these two drugs are used in the name of Pata. Mainly in the Pata, the root is used. And sometimes even the leaves are also used. Pata is mainly used in case of Atisara, Arsha, Prameha. And especially in the Prameha, type of Prameha, that is Lavanameha, will use Pata Agru Kashaya Pramehinam. Pata Agru Kashaya Pramehinam. In the case of Lavanameha especially. And it is also a very good drug in case of Atisara Arshas. It acts as a very good grahi. And it is also used in the folk that the leaf paste is applied on the forehead to relieve the Shirashula.